The following program is brought to you in living color on...
Dude, this is radio. There's no visuals. It can't be in color.
Oh, sorry. Anyway, please enjoy this special presentation.
Good evening, all you gentle people, and welcome to WJMU's 2018 Holiday Special. My name is Crosby Bingsley, and I'll be your master of ceremonies for this nice, quiet little get-together. I've invited a few of the popular radio hosts here at WJMU to entertain you one last time before we all go home for winter break, and they've all planned something very special for all of you.
What in the Sam Hill... Who are you and what are you doing in our studio?
I'm Crosby Bingsley, and I'm here to host the Holiday Special.
Holiday Special? I didn't know we were doing a Holiday Special.
Yes, well...
Hey, Crosby.
How are you, my dude?
Well, I'll be. Here's our first pair of guests already.
Wait, what should I do
for... What a pleasure to have you two over. It's Jordan Comish and Megan Whitlock of Turn Back Tuesday, everybody. Are you ready to go on?
You bet.
All right, then. The microphones are all yours.
Thank you. Okay, well, here we go. Our little Christmas special deal.
So, we normally listen to songs and, you know, look up the history about the year they were released, but we're just going to give you cool backgrounds on what happened on Christmas Day. So, probably some surprising facts. We did this for... Halloween as well, and there were some like really crazy things that happened on Halloween. Like I think Houdini died.
Yeah,
and I didn't
yeah.
know that. Like some war started on Halloween as well, and there was a few other things that happened. But we're gonna focus on Christmas, so we're gonna throw out some cool facts about what happened on Christmas Day.
Yeah, there we go. Well, way back in the day, in the year 1066, it says William the Conqueror crowned King of England. The leader of the Norman invaders took the throne in Westminster Abbey. Ever since, no one word has conveyed the idea of strength quite like Norman.
Norman. You know, when I hear that name, I don't really think about a strong man.
Yeah, like conqueror.
No. Right. So I think that's interesting that English people find the name Norman to be... mighty. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, it's not necessarily like a weak name, but it doesn't really strike conqueror into my head, you know?
When I think of the name Norman, I think of that guy from Phineas and Ferb. You know, Dr. Doofenshmirtz, robot friend, Norman. That's what I think about.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, random, but...
That was a good show.
Was
ultimately
a good
show. All right, in 1977, Charlie Chaplin dies on Christmas Day. Ooh.
Sad. I hope he got to open his presents first.
Oh, that is sad.
He was 88, though.
Yeah, yeah.
But apparently, he made headlines 2 months after because grave robbers stole his casket and demanded ransom for its return. Isn't that crazy?
Oh,
someone just, like, stole his dead body and was like, give us money or we won't give it back.
And who would even, like, who would pay that? Is there, like, an association of people that pays for celebrities' bodies?
Maybe. Probably his family, but... I mean, still, like, why are you just gonna take a body? Like, that just doesn't...
Kind of rude.
Yeah, that just... It's a very odd idea to get money.
True.
But, I don't know. And then in 1899, Humphrey Bogart was born. So... That's cool. All I know about him is that he was the star of Gone with the Wind.
I was gonna say, you know more than I do, because I don't know anything about who that is.
He was a pretty big deal in like the 1940s and 50s. He was like, I think that was the year. Maybe earlier. Maybe 1920s, 30s.
I guess
30s.
He'd be about 40 or 50.
I'm probably wrong in my years. Don't quote me. But I just know that he was like America's heartthrob at one point because of Gone with the Wind.
Oh, very good.
So yeah, that's about it.
According to this record that we found conveniently online, the year 336 was the first recorded year that Christmas was celebrated.
You've been doing this a long time.
Yeah.
Christmas.
Literally thousands of years. Almost thousands.
Almost thousands.
Almost 2,000 years.
We won't be around for the 2,000th Christmas, but that's okay.
True. Fair. To Kill a Mockingbird came out on Christmas Day in 1962. Very good. A very good novel. I had to read it in high school.
I mean, of course I did too. I think that's just like the normal standard for like 10th graders. I think it's just interesting that they chose to release it on Christmas Day.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously it still did really well. So, it doesn't really matter when it was released, I guess.
Maybe it was a big deal back in the day that if you were to release something on Christmas, then it would somehow become the Christmas present, you know, for people.
Well, I mean, you would have already had to buy Christmas presents, right?
Yeah, I don't know how the culture was back then.
Me either. I mean, 1962, I definitely wasn't around, so.
True, I also was not around. In 1991, Gorbachev quits. Nice. I know he was a Russian leader. That's all I got. I don't know about you, I'm pretty bad with history for doing a history show.
I mean, I'm pretty good about history. I mean, this is normally like pop culture stuff, but like, you know, sometimes we get really into history with these things. I was more like, you know, like the Game Boy was invented on this day, like this happened. But sometimes we get just like deep stuff, like in 1991 on Christmas Day, the USSR was disbanded, you know? So sometimes
pretty different than just Game Boys.
Oh yeah, Game Boys, TV shows, like in 2001 Shrek came out. Nice.
did you know that? I don't know when Shrek came out.
2001, Shrek came out.
Now I know. Perfect. You can learn something from the show, truly.
Yes, important stuff.
You really can.
In 1776, this is pretty common knowledge, but Washington crossed the Delaware on Christmas night into Christmas Day. And I could say that's common knowledge, but a lot of people probably don't know, so we're just going to restate it.
Wait, now was that the night of Christmas Eve into Christmas Day?
Yes.
Or was, okay.
All night.
So not Christmas night into the next day, but
you
it was Christmas Eve into Christmas Day.
Yes.
So right,
about 6
okay.
p.m. on Christmas.
On the night of Christmas Eve.
Yes.
Christmas.
In 1776, on Christmas Day, Washington did that thing where he crossed the river. There you go. The Delaware River, to be more specific. And then about in July, they won the war, so it took them a few months, but they got there. And, you know, that's about all the fun facts we have for Christmas.
Yeah, that's about it.
So I guess we're going to throw it back to Crosby. And,
yeah.
He's going to take back over, and maybe some other hosts will have some good stuff for you. That's about all we have. Thanks for tuning in to our Turn Back Tuesday special.
On WJMU.
89.5, The Quad. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
And now for our next...
Hey, Mr. Bingsley, I've got an idea for something I could do for my segment.
You don't really need to worry about that, pal.
No. I should pull my weight here like everyone else does. So, I was thinking...
Hold that thought, buddy. Let me just answer the door here. Well, I'll be. It's the Psych Professor and DJ Mellow Yellow of the Psychedelic Experience. How are you gentlemen doing?
Fine, man. How about you, Mr. Bingsley?
I'm doing just fine. I can't wait to see what sweet psychedelic symphonies you brought for us tonight.
Well, you won't have to wait much longer. We're ready and raring to go.
Great. Take it away, then.
Well, this is a track we played a couple years ago on one of our Christmas specials by a Japanese group called the He5. This is their take on Jingle Bells featuring an Inagata DeVita breakdown. So,
I only vaguely remember this.
Oh, I listen to this all the time during Christmas. So, here we go. The He5 on the Psychedelic Experience, 89.5 The Quad. Thank you.
This is just enjoyable. Sounds like a Telecaster?
Probably.
Okay.
Yeah. A little surf influence.
Yeah, definitely.
It's about simple, to get crazy, though.
Simple.
Yeah.
Kind of rudimentary recording technology, maybe.
Very much so, yeah.
All right. I like that element here. It's Christmassy.
It is.
And I like the tone.
Yeah. A little reverb there, I think.
Yes. Very nice.
Maybe a little wah-wah.
A little bit. Definitely some, and high end fuzz.
Yes.
On the or back end fuzz, I should say.
Right.
On the guitar there. Drums, not really tuned.
No. Not really mic'd up either.
I like that though. Yeah. I think that's one of the elements that I like of older rock recordings. You know, before. Oh, 17 mics on the drum set.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get me wrong, that can be cool. Doesn't sound raw, though. Now we're getting raw.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Uh-oh, the brown acid kicked in here, folks. Avoid the eggnog.
Rudolph found the good stuff.
Oh, man. I was going to drink eggnog on the air here this evening. Bring my nog chalice.
Ooh, boy.
Well, I've got a quart of eggnog for today's the last day.
Oh, so if you go a little farther, you're risking something.
I guess. I might have a trip like this.
That's right.
Might get taken. I don't know what's in eggnog. I assume it's eggs.
I would assume so.
Yeah.
Maybe a 3 a.m. bathroom trip in there somewhere, but you know. Get a little fever mixed in with that, you'll definitely be seeing stuff.
Yeah, boy. Bathroom floor. Things are moving.
Yeah. And not just my bowels.
Oh, gross.
Yeah.
So I do like this breakdown here.
Yeah.
Now we've got the wah.
Yes. This is the Holy Grail Christmas album for me.
Is it really?
It really is.
What does one of these bad boys retail for?
They do not show up often. When they do, they're expensive. I mean, like $1,000.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow. So I'll never find one. But, you know, a guy can dream.
What's the group again?
The He-5.
The
He-5. Yep, He-5.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here's the cool thing about this. I can also see this like in a Kenji Suzuki movie. Kenji Suzuki,
yeah.
Like with like a dude like walking out of an office building with like a double barrel shotgun under his trench coat, black and white. We get the wide shot, then we get the medium shot, then we get the follow along. Yeah,
I like it.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, mid-60s Japanese assassin pictures.
Yes,
good stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just slow it down a little. Sludgy.
Yeah. And I think he's got that that hi-hat a little tight.
Mm-hmm.
Loosen it up a little bit, man. Get a little resonance.
Yeah. All right. A little boost of adrenaline there.
Yeah, we're back in.
Yeah, the fuzz fed him.
Yeah. When, one of the best, quote, like, Bart pranks ever on The Simpsons was when he switched out the church hymn music for, and put, like, in the Garden of Eden on page 427.
Yeah.
And then it like cuts to the organist and she like passes out. We'll paint it black in there.
That's like
nice.
That.
Yeah, they were just they were like, yeah, what's popular right now? Let's throw it all in
totally.
There. What do we cover during our show?
Oh, I wish there was live footage of this.
Oh, man.
It'd be fun to watch.
This isn't a live recording, though, right? This is studio?
This is studio,
okay, yeah.
I'm assuming one take studio recording is my guess, but I don't know that to be true.
Maybe, yeah. What do you think? Were these guys part of the square community who knew how to rock, or were they true hippies?
That's a good question. They have a lot of records.
Okay.
They were a pretty prolific kind of surf rock group, but so I'm assuming they were probably pretty cool, but it might be like The Ventures too or something, you know, where it's like, oh, they just had a lot of output and they knew how to play this.
Yep.
But they were just
a lot of sweaters.
Yeah. Yeah. I think their shtick was that they wore like suits. In fact, why don't we look this up? They have suits on, but they're kind of cool. They've got some sunglasses on. Yeah. There's a copy for sale right now for $2,500.
Oh, wow. Okay, wow. Let me just, I think I'm getting a small raise this year.
So. Yeah. And you know what? I said Japanese. It looks like they're from South Korea, actually. So
wow.
My apologies.
Wow. Culturally sensitive much? No, you aren't.
I always wanted to go visit my cousin in South Korea for the purpose of looking for this record.
I always wanted to go visit your cousin in South Korea, too.
Oh.
Matt's cousin is female.
Yes, yeah.
Oh, that's too funny. It is fun to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. I've never done it, personally. Yeah. I've only heard tell. Doesn't the concept of a sleigh, like, at the point where, you know, where we're at with global warming, you're like, nobody's going to know what this is 200 years from
now. Yeah, it's so true. And there it is. And then it goes into a... another Christmas tune after that. So that that was Jingle Bells from the He-5.
Mm.
South Korea's surf rock.
South Korea's own.
Yes.
Well, that was a lot of fun. And now for station identification, followed by a brief message from the fine folks at Bloca Cola.
You're listening to 89.5 WJMU The Quad.
I just tried a zesty blood orange diet Bloca Cola for the first time, and I broke up with my boyfriend. Well, kinda. I mean, I didn't really say it in so many words. I just kinda knocked him unconscious, stuffed him in a crate of Hamdingers, and sent him to the middle of nowhere in China to die. I think he got the message. It's just, drinking that diet Bloca Cola, it reminded me that I like having spice in my life. Well, I suppose zest isn't really spice, but still, it reminded me that I like exotic flavors, like blood orange. And not just blood orange, zesty blood orange. And he just couldn't give me that zest I needed.
Miss, I only asked if you wanted something to drink before you ordered your food.
Oh, I'll have a Sprite.
Ugh!
Diet Bloca Cola, because I might. But not right now.
Well, that was a lot of fun. And now I'd like to sing you all a song.
I got it! I finally got it, Mr. Bingsley! I figured out what I'm going to do for my segment.
You did? How wonderful. What are you going to do?
The thing I do best. A rerun.
A what?
All this time, I was racking my brain over something brand spanking new and elaborate, when all I really needed to do was revisit the old classics. And I learned that from listening to everyone's segments.
Well, kid, are you going to do your segment or not?
Oh, right. First, let me give it a good intro.
All right.
Every December, cable channels like Hallmark and Lifetime churn out subpar holiday movie after subpar holiday movie. And no matter how bad they are, they just keep on pulling in viewers. Well, last year, I decided I'd throw my hat into that ring and see if I could score some viewers with some sentimental holiday schlock. It did not work. Anyway, here is the fruit of all my labors.
Hi, Mom. How's Bora Bora?
Absolutely wonderful, my dear. Listen, Corinne, you and I need to have a little chat about something.
Sure. What is it?
I just got the credit card bill for this month. Would you mind explaining to me why you saw it fit to spend $10,000 on one singular gummy candy?
It wasn't just any gummy candy, Mom. It was the gummy de Milo. Alexandros. What?
You need to learn how to be responsible with money. You can't keep suckling from my metaphorical teat forever.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. I'm 50, dammit. I want to go out and live my life without having to worry about you driving us both to the poorhouse.
Please, Mom, can't we just talk this over?
We just did. Good luck, Corinne.
Rats.
Your mother's completely cut you off financially? That really sucks.
I know, Heather. I mean, like, the worst part is she refuses to see things from my point of view. You saw the gummy de Milo.
For a split second. Then you ate it.
You're not helping, Heather.
I'm not here to help. I'm here to mock. In the last third of the movie, I'll actually help you, but for now, I'm just here to make wisecracks and try to get you to laugh at your own misfortune.
Hey, Corinne. What's wrong?
My mother cut me off financially, and I have no idea what to do with my life. I'm all alone now. Who will take care of me? Oh, I'll starve to death! Meadows!
Well, have you considered getting a job?
You said a bad word.
There's nothing wrong with doing good, honest work.
You forget, Sitlali. Our friend Corinne was born with a silver spoon in her mouth. By the way, I also spout cliches to try to sound more poetic and wise than I really am.
Well, Heather, our friend Corinne is going to have to learn to take care of herself and provide for herself and pay taxes just like every other adult in America if she wants to survive. And it just so happens that the ad agency I work for is hiring.
Opportunity's knocking, Corinne.
Will you put a good word in for me, Sitlali?
Of course. But you have to do all the hard work yourself, okay?
Okay. Hello, Mr. Brannigan?
What do you want?
I'm Corinne Matthews, Sitlali's friend. I'm here for my interview.
All right then, let's cut to the chase. I'm a very busy man. Do you have any prior experience in the field of advertising?
Well, no. I don't have much experience in anything, really, except life. I'm a full-fledged student of life. People! If there's one thing I know, it's people. And if there's one thing any good ad agency needs, it's a thorough knowledge of people. So what do you say, Mr. Brannigan?
You've got spunk, kid. I hate spunk. You're hired!
What? Really?
You're just what I need in this office. A reason to go home to the wife.
Oh.
That's just one of the many comically misogynistic things I'll be saying throughout the movie, to establish myself as a grumpy, jaded old man who takes himself too seriously. Rest assured, however, that when you screw up royally, and you will, because you're the quirky protagonist, I'll be the first person to defend you.
Thank you, Mr. Brannigan. You won't regret this.
I will, actually. But that will just be more motivation for you to work harder to fix whatever situation you manage to get this company in.
Okay, so when do I start?
Tomorrow. That way you have tonight to celebrate with your friends in a sappy montage set to a cheerful but overplayed song.
Great!
All right, Matthews, now that you've done your celebrating, it's time for you to meet some of your coworkers. This is Brody Clark.
Hey, girl. Ooh, I love that scarf on you. Brings out your eyes, makes you look fierce.
Whoa, what is your deal?
I'm the gay supporting character who's pretty much just an amalgam of various outdated stereotypes and is pretty obviously not played by an actual gay person, because what gay person would take a role like this?
Can we, like, not do this now? I mean, it's 2017, for God's sake.
Fine. I was gonna serve as a worldly sage and give you advice that would never actually work in real life, but you can forget that now.
I didn't do too good there, did I?
Nope. Well, here's another one of your co-workers, Pauline Doyle.
I can tell just by looking at you that you're incompetent and are not to be trusted. One false move and I'll swoop in to seemingly be your undoing, except not really, because you're the protagonist and everything works out well for you in the end. Expect me to be very distant.
Jeez, I didn't even do anything that time.
No matter. Here's the last of your co-workers I'm going to introduce you to, because really you're not going to interact much with the others on screen. This is Ian Donovan.
I work hard here. This ad agency is my life. If it fails, that means I'm a failure, and my father never loved me. Also, my mother is dead, so I'm also going to be very distant.
Ian is going to be your partner in trying to get a really big account for us. Don't screw it up.
I won't, Mr. Brannigan.
Alright, we've got 3 weeks to come up with a great new ad for this new cereal McCrae Foods is trying to push for the Christmas season. Puffed grass.
Why is it a weird one? Why can't it be something like a phone service or something useful like that?
Well, the writers got a little tipsy when they wrote this part, and no one had the heart to tell them. So let's just roll with it. Anyway, I've already come up with a pretty neat ad campaign. So let's present it like we both worked on it. Meaning I'll do all the talking and you just chime in wherever. Just try not to sound stupid, okay?
Okay.
So what do you think of it, Mr. Brannigan?
It stinks. I won't specify how. I'll just give you some vague critique that will force you two to bond. It needs more heart.
Heart?
Yes. You gotta have heart. All you really need is heart. When the odds are saying you'll never win, that's when the grin should start. Is any of this getting to you?
No, not really.
It's inspired me, sir. Come on, Ian, let's work on a new campaign and bond in the process.
I don't wanna.
Donovan.
Fine. And that's why my mother's death led me to be distant with people.
I feel like I've known you for years now. I still have no idea what to do for this ad campaign, though. What am I gonna do, Seat Lolly? Not only do Ian and I have less than a week to come up with a good ad campaign for Puffed Grass, but I think I'm falling in love with him, and I'm his secret Santa.
I'm afraid your troubles don't end there, Corinne.
What do you mean?
I got the results of the test back. I definitely have breast cancer.
Do you think we really ought to be referencing all these non-Hallmark movies? I mean, isn't it going to be kind of confusing?
Who cares? I'm dying!
I'm sorry I'm so out of it today, Ian. It's just so hard seeing her get weaker and weaker. I mean, she's my best friend.
I know how you feel. I felt the same way when it happened with my mother.
Yeah, and I've known Seat Lolly since high school. She's like the sister I never had. That's it! Family! We'll make the ad about family. Everybody loves families. It's perfect.
I'm not prone to huge displays of emotion. But I will join you in expressing great joy. So what do you think of our ad campaign, Mr. McCrae?
It stinks. It's so horribly mushy and cliché. It makes me want to gag. It's perfect! Brannigan, you've got some brilliant young minds at your firm. I'm going to give you all my business from here on out until I die.
Yay!
Hey, Ian. Congrats on landing the Puffed Grass account.
Thanks. Well, I can't take all the credit. Corinne came up with the main idea of the whole thing.
She did, huh?
She's not as incompetent as I thought. I guess I won't be serving as a temporary stumbling block for her after all.
Hey, more reason to celebrate. Want to get lunch together?
Sure.
I can't believe it. Ian just asked another woman out to lunch, and now I'm pretty sure I'm in love with him. Also, the whole Secret Santa thing, can't forget that.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, I'm officially in remission now.
It's a Festivus miracle.
That does make me feel better, but I'm still sad about Ian.
Well, I think the best option is to be honest and straightforward about how you feel.
Do you really think that'll help, Heather?
Hey, you are the protagonist. What could possibly go wrong?
Pauline, can we talk?
Eh, what the hell? I'm in a good mood. What do you want to talk about?
I wanted to talk about you and Ian.
I already know where this is going. There is absolutely nothing between me and him.
Don't give me that. I know you like Ian too. Well, you're not good enough for him because you're too aloof and I brought him out of his shell and that makes him mine, so there.
You do know I'm gay, right?
What?
I'm gay.
But Hallmark movies don't have lesbians in them.
This one does. Progress, biatch!
You can't use that word in
I'll talk however I want. Now that my lackluster character arc in this lackluster movie has ended, I'm free! Free!
Ian, it's been a great pleasure working with you these past few weeks.
I already know where this is going.
Am I that predictable?
No, we're just short on time, and I've read ahead in the script. Anyway, I know you've developed feelings for me, and while I'm still not entirely comfortable with admitting it, I reciprocate those feelings.
Woohoo!
Also, I know you're my secret Santa. I want a choo-choo train, the kind that cries and wets itself.
You've got it, baby.
Here's another quick message from our other sponsor, Slime Co. Insurance. But first, station ID.
You're listening to WJMU 89.5, The Quad.
Every time I see you looking my way, baby, baby, can't you hear my heartbeat? Hello.
Daddy, hello. Can I ask you a question?
Sure, Pumpkin.
Where do babies come from?
I think your mom can explain it better.
Mom just left for the grocery store.
You see, when a mommy and daddy love each other very much, they call Slime Co. and save 15% or more on car insurance?
And?
And what?
And how do they get a baby?
Wow, I thought that would work. Well, maybe your grandmother would know
She's
how.
Out walking the dog.
Well, your Aunt Judy is a science teacher. She'd probably...
She lives all the way in Poughkeepsie.
Oh. Well, maybe Mrs. Trumbull next door
Mrs.
can...
Mrs. Trumbull's been dead for 5 years. Look, Dad, if you don't know, just say it. I'm a very busy girl, and I haven't got time for all this fooling around.
Fine. I don't know. Now let's never talk about this again.
Okay, whatever. There's just one other question I have.
What is it?
What's an orgasm?
Switching to Slime Co. to save 15% or more on car insurance is always the right answer. And now for our final segment, which will begin as soon as our final guests arrive.
Sorry we're late.
Yeah, it's finals week and we're still swamped with a lot of work.
What do you mean we're swamped with a lot of work?
Okay. What I mean to say is I'm swamped with work and you just forgot the time of our program.
You got me there.
All right. In all fairness, probably wouldn't be swamped if I actually kept up to date with some of my assignments. Sorry, Crosby. We're not too late, are we?
Oh, no. You're right on time.
That's a first, right, Jason?
You did it again, Avenue.
I'm sorry. You know, maybe I wouldn't keep doing that if you hadn't picked a DJ name so close to your real name.
Hey, stop oppressing me.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Calm down, you two. Save the arguments for your segment.
Right. Sorry.
How about you two just get started, okay?
Sure. Hit the theme music.
Here's a real high-class bout. It's on.
I'm sorry, your opinion means very little to me.
Sometimes it's fun to be the bad guy.
Oh, you're right. And when you're right, you're right. And you, you're always right.
And a little open discussion never hurt anyone.
Hey guys, you're listening to WJMU 89.5, The Quad.
More specifically, you're listening to the holiday segment of Devil's Advocate with me, Avenue.
And me, DJ Jaybird. So we're here tonight to spread some Christmas cheer and all the other holiday cheer. I only celebrate Christmas, but, you know, that's not the most important one. Regardless, though, you know, we're happy to be with you guys tonight. We're happy to be with everybody else in the studio having a fun time.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to, you know, just start off with some of our witty banter, like always. We're going to talk
about... Is it witty banter if you call it witty banter and it's forced?
Everything I do in my life is forced, okay? So let's just think about it that way.
All right, already oversharing. We're 30 seconds in.
30 seconds in. So finals week. Let's just start with that real quick. Very stressing. Yeah, I'm a little behind on some of my stuff, but I'm catching up. I always see things through to the end, you know, make it good.
Persevere.
Yeah, I know. I haven't slept in like, what day is it? I'll figure out that math later, but it's been a while since I've slept.
That's concerning.
Yeah, it's all good. I've only got five more papers to write, like big papers, and I think two more tests. So I'm in the good.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. How about you? You ready for finals to be?
Yeah, I got a couple papers, got a couple exams, have to, you know, teach myself French, but other than that, it's fine. We're doing great.
See, at least I don't have to teach myself a language. I'm gonna take that as a win.
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna just jump right into it, guys. We're gonna talk about one of the biggest things I think about during the holidays. Is it better to receive or give?
Presents.
I don't understand why the presents. Like, what else would I be talking about?
Anyway. Is it better to give or receive presents during Christmas?
Okay, I'll let you start with that.
I like to give.
Yeah.
Presents.
Okay. What about giving presents, which is good?
I mean, I personally don't like spend a lot of money necessarily on presents, but I do like to like just get something small for most people in my life. But I really honestly don't care if I get something back. Like I say that with true sincerity. Like I could give someone a present and I really don't care if they have one for me. But I never like go overboard. I think it's kind of annoying when people get like super huge expensive presents and then they're like, oh, don't worry about getting anything from me, and then you kind of feel like obligated.
All right, yeah, I get that. So like, I know I don't want to say I act altruistic, but like I think a lot of people would think of me as that way. I love giving, but there's a caveat to that. With a lot of my friends, it's just like, I don't know if it's just like the type of people they are, but they don't ever think about giving a present. You know, I don't need a present to be happy. But, you know, sometimes you give a lot of people stuff, and, like some of my friends back home, love them to death, but I think I could count how many birthday presents I've gotten all of them, and, like, the time I've ever gotten a birthday present from them.
Really?
Know? Yeah, it's not a big deal, but, you know, I think that's one of the bad things that comes around during the holiday time. Whether you do try to think about it or not, whether you actually care about it or not, I feel like sometimes that's always in your head a little bit, you know?
Oh, yeah.
No matter how good of a person you are.
I texted my best friend last week and said, hey, I'm having difficulties thinking of a present for you. Can we just not this year? And she said, yeah, that she doesn't care if we give each other presents, but I actually saw something online today and I got her a present. So I should probably tell her I got her a present.
So you're the worst. You're a scumbag.
Well, it was really cheap though. See, that's the thing. I'm going to tell her like it was really not expensive. I saw it. I thought of you and I got it. So that's what I think are good presents. Like if you see something and you say, wow, this person would really like it, or this really reminds me of my friend, I know they'd really appreciate it and get it for them, rather than just like, oh, I have to go buy someone a present.
That is the thing. Like, thinking about the perfect gift for someone and, like, seeing their face when they see it, or just knowing, like, it's going to be good for them. Like, I already gave my one roommate, Kevin Miller, his Christmas present, because it's, like, half Christmas, half birthday. His birthday was in November something, so it works out. But he's on the basketball team. And for those of you that don't know, basketball players really don't get to go home for winter break.
Mm-hmm.
So as a gift, Kevin's been into Vikings for such a long time. Now, he's not the biggest video game player in the world, but he loves Vikings and Norse mythology. And this year, God of War came out. And Black Friday came around, it was super cheap, and I bought him God of War while I'm leaving my PS4 over in the apartment over break. So that way he has something to do during all those days where they're just stuck in the apartment without family or, you know, stuff. And I felt really happy about giving it to him. At one point, my brother's like, let's play the God of War game. I'm like, Daniel, I bought this present for him. I'm not going to open a new gift and play it for myself first. I'm like, I'm not that big of a monster.
I've been really into jewelry this season. Like, not on purpose, but I got my mom something that's jewelry related. I got two of my best friends.
Oh, giving out jewelry, not like wanting jewelry
for
Christmas.
No, like, I've been seeing a lot of geared ads toward me on my social media. It was around Black Friday. I saw a lot of ads for nicer brands that had really good deals, you know, and they were really spot on because I sure clicked on those ads and I did buy a couple things from the ads that were generated for my profile. So yeah, I don't know why, but this year jewelry has been a thing for me. I've gotten like 5 different people things that were like jewelry related accessories.
See, what I've been doing lately is kind of the lazy man's way out, but my mom got like a t-shirt maker and like one of those good ones where it's like, you know, it can get up to 1,000 degrees, so stay away from it because it will hurt you if you use it wrong. Like, and like, they stay, they last, they don't, they're not just iron-ons.
Mm-hmm.
So making my friends personalized t-shirts is always a good, cool way to do it. Like,
I like personalized t-shirts. I think they're cool.
Like, no one else is ever gonna have a shirt like it, or and on top of that, it shows that you know them. You know,
right.
You can, like, last year I put sayings on them for everybody. Like, Alex has said, "You're the worst," which is just something we say to each other all the time, you know? I just love the whole, I guess we're both on the same page then. Giving is way better than receiving.
Yeah. I mean, I can't deny that I like getting gifts.
Oh, absolutely not. I'm going to take what you give me.
Right. But I don't sit there and say, like, you know, keep score of what friends gave me what. I really couldn't care less.
I get that. All right.
I am more of a, I think it goes to my love language, though, because I am way more of a quality time type person. So I care more about, did you spend time with me over the holidays? That's what I care about. I don't really care if you got me a gift.
Makes sense. Okay, I got a quick question, though, before we move on to something else. What do you do when you get a gift that you don't like?
Well, I would always just pretend I like it.
Right. But, like, what do you do with it? Do you use it on purpose so that people, you know?
It really depends what it is, because, like, you can get gifts that aren't necessarily bad, but you just don't need them.
Right.
And that's what I mean when, like, I don't really care about the amount of gifts, because my, like, stepmom will always get me nice, like, gifting specifically makeup, because you can go to, like, Ulta, Sephora and buy gift packages of makeup. And it's just a lot of stuff that I don't need or want, and so I don't end up using it. And so it just kind of sits in my room in this cute little Christmas package that I never really open. And it was like, the thought was nice because I'm a girl, I wear makeup, I must want it, right? But in reality, like, my mom, who knows me a little bit better than my stepmom, would never go buy me that because she knows I'm not going to wear that. It's not my brand. It's not what I wear. I don't really wear makeup that often. My mom gets me things that are like, she mentioned that she wanted this 2 months ago, and I remember because I'm a mom and I remember these things. So she goes and buys a like, perfect present.
Yep.
And it might not be very expensive, but it's like something I actually want and I'll use. So I would rather get like a couple presents that I will actually incorporate into my life.
Then just get a present because it's a present.
Because it's a present. And when I get those things, I'll say thank you, I like it. Obviously, I don't return it or anything like that. I just keep it in my room and I never touch it.
Exactly. And it's the whole idea that someone still thought about you and got you something.
Yeah.
All right. Do you have any presents? Like any items you're kind of like hoping you get this year?
Honestly, the only thing that I hope I get is some silver rings or bracelets, because I am a gold jewelry wearer and I have a couple like really nice things that I never wear because I don't have other things to go with it. So I know that's so oddly specific, but I want silver jewelry.
Okay, well, I mean, I want skulls and flasks, so.
Flasks.
There you go. Yeah, well, you know, I collect both of those things. So like last year for Christmas, my grandmother got me this really cool skull that had like a fake spider on it. And it's like, it's probably one of my favorite skulls. And, you know, like my family knows I have that collection. So like it's always like a cool little unique thing that like anyone who knows that that's my type of thing, it's kind of cool when I get one, you know?
Interesting.
And it's not like something I parade around, but like whenever I show people my room, when it's not a total disaster. I'm like, yeah, this is my collection. Here's all my flasks. And then they think I'm an alcoholic. And then I have to explain that no, they're just for show.
Are these flasks like go to Target, get a flask, or are they like nice ones?
Well, it all depends. So like I've got one from when I went on a cruise to like from somewhere, St. John. I got like this really cool one that my mom must have got online. There's one from Target that says it's lit. You know, I have like 8, 9 right now. One from Vegas. One of my favorite ones my mom got in Switzerland. And you know the Swiss Army knife?
Mm-hmm.
It's got a nice felt cover that's got the Swiss symbol on it. So,
cool.
But yeah. So flasks and skulls.
Interesting. Yeah. I would never have guessed.
Well, I mean, you know me, I like to be edgy. So.
All right.
My real personality doesn't fit it that much. All right, let's talk about our next thing.
Christmas movies.
We're going to jump straight to Christmas movies?
Yeah.
All right, I'm down. Okay. I'm going to start with my favorite Christmas movie, since my favorite Christmas movie is your normal type of Christmas movie. For me, two of my favorites are I Love Jingle All the Way, starring...
What the heck is that?
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Oh my god.
Have you ever seen it? It's a Christmas movie starring him. It's also got Sinbad in it.
No.
It's so good. And it's like,
sounds terrible.
Okay, but here's the thing. It's all about a father trying to get a toy for his son.
And vomit.
And like he forgot to get his son a present.
Of course.
Yeah, because men are the worst, obviously. And he like has to run around through town trying to find like the most wanted item of the year, you know, to show that his son
he realizes in the end he doesn't need a present. His son just wants his love. Is that what happens?
Yeah, but I don't like the attack on my favorite movie.
Jason loves predictable movies. That's his cup of tea.
If you haven't seen it, though, then you don't know. You don't know all the great
fun. I just told you what happened.
You didn't see it, though.
You know what's a Christmas movie? You know what's a good movie? Die Hard. That is the best Christmas movie there is.
Mm.
It's got action. It's got heart.
Where's my
buzzer?
It's
got great one-liners, such as... Yippee-ki-yay, mother beef.
Fudger.
Mother
but
fudger.
I didn't say fudge.
It's got great music. It's set on Christmas Eve. It's got all the 80s nostalgia. It's everything you need and want.
It's got Bruce Willis.
Bruce Willis. Is it actually? It's 90s, isn't it?
Yeah, it is 90s.
90s.
But I didn't want to correct you.
I said 80s.
Yeah, it's fine. I don't know. I don't get into an action-y mood during Christmas.
I like some Christmas movies of the more traditional want to vomit kind of cuteness.
Thanks.
Such
Thanks.
As
great.
Like I like Elf. I can't watch more than once a year because it's too much for me. My mom loves that movie. I like Christmas Vacation. That one's hilarious. Yeah, a classic. Yeah. Definitely got to watch that every year. But as for like other than that, it's really just probably It's a Wonderful Life. That one is classic, get you in the feels type movie. But Die Hard is my go-to. I have to watch that every Christmas season.
See, besides Jingle All the Way, which is like the nostalgia factor for me, like I used to watch that when it wasn't Christmas as a child. Like,
Home Alone. I love Home Alone, too.
Home Alone is great on all of them. And yes, there's like 5 of them.
Home Alone's a good one.
Only the first 2 are worth watching. Honestly, Miracle on 34th Street.
I've seen that a couple times.
But have you seen the original or have you seen the
original.
Remake? Because I love the remake. The remake is really good.
Hmm.
It's... really good. Also, my mom made me a shirt that's like got the Believe, kind of like the buttons that they all made in the movie. It's really cool. What's with all the Netflix Christmas movies being made?
Okay, I have to admit something.
Which one? Did you see The Christmas Prince?
No, I did not watch The Christmas Prince, but did you see The Princess Switch on
Netflix?
Did
you watch The Princess Switch?
Yes, it has Vanessa Hudgens in it. So what happened was me and my 2 friends were home for Thanksgiving weekend. We're sitting in the basement. We're going through Netflix. We see Vanessa Hudgens is in this Christmas movie, and we're like, what is this? It was terrible. Absolutely atrocious. The writing was terrible. The acting... not good. I love Vanessa Hudgens, and it was really just garbage. And it really reminded me as to why I do not branch out with Christmas movies and why I should really stick with the classics such as Die Hard. Because things like Netflix and Hallmark movies...
Okay, Hallmark movies are a different thing in general. Me and our friend Allison the other day, we hung out. We were watching a bad Christmas movie on purpose. And
where
making
was
fun
I?
Of-
I didn't get a text about Here's a Christmas movie night.
I was trying to rotate around. It was during the night when the tornado was happening.
So Vespers.
Yeah. You were busy.
But I still would have liked the text.
I hang out with
You know, it's the thought that counts, people.
You're right. In spirit, we wanted you there, but, like, in reality, no. So.
All right.
By the way, if you ever get the chance to watch Christmas Crush, it's hilarious.
Every Hallmark movie is the exact same.
I would definitely want to call my next significant other Sport. Because that's what, like, her dream guy the entire movie, who's, you know, the stereotypical jerk that she really shouldn't be with.
Oh, yeah.
The entire movie was calling her Sport. Like, that was their cute pet name, and I'm like,
anything that's like sport, kid, all that stuff, sexist. Just throwing that out there. It all comes from a place of the man feeling like he's in a place of power.
Whatever, kiddo. Anyway.
All right. You really should stop while you're ahead.
Is there anything else we want to talk about? Let's talk about holiday desserts just real quick. What do you think about when you think of, like, holiday dessert?
I literally don't eat dessert on Christmas, so you got me there. What do you eat on Christmas?
What's wrong with you? Okay, first off, candy, but it has to be red or green, obviously.
See, I'm not a candy person. Next.
Candy canes.
Next.
Hot chocolate.
I'd rather drink coffee.
See, but you can have, like, so many variations, like peppermint mochas, like, for, like, in terms of coffee, that can be a dessert too if you do it right. Eggnog. Oh, coffee.
Never had eggnog.
Coffee with eggnog instead of cream. One of my favorite things about Christmas.
I've never had eggnog before.
Missing out. Also, eggnog with bourbon, I hear, is good. That's good.
I hear that coffee and Bailey's is good.
It is good. That's also another holiday tradition.
I've never tried it. I've never tasted alcohol in my life, so I wouldn't know.
Yeah. You don't turn 21 till the summer. That sucks. I'm trying to think if there's anything else Christmas dessert related. Like, people think pie, but I feel like there's
That's Thanksgiving.
I feel like there's not a good Christmas dessert besides candy. Wait, I lied. Cookies.
Christmas cookies. Mom will make peanut butter cookies, and she makes Raisin Puff cookies for my sister. I hate Raisin Puff cookies. I don't even eat them. She makes an entire, like, 3 dozen batch just for my sister. She never eats all of them.
See, my mom makes, like, 10 batches of, like, 10 different types of cookies.
My mom makes always peanut butter cookies with the little fork prongs in the middle.
Yeah, I know what you're talking
about. And then she makes butter cookies that sit in, like, tins, and they get better as they, like, sit there. Do you know what I'm talking about?
I know what you're talking about.
And it's just kind of, like, little broken up pieces of, like, dough, basically. Those are really good. She puts them in Christmas tins. I think that would be the only Christmas dessert I eat.
We get the traditional chocolate chip cookies, which, you know, homemade chocolate chip cookies. I honestly think there's nothing better in the world than that. These chocolate smushy cookies that we call them, and they're, like, made of, like, almonds and nuts and chocolate, but, like, they're just, like, chewy. It's so good. My mom always makes me a lemon cookie because she knows I like that. I'm all about that citrus life.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah, but anyway. Holidays are right around the corner.
They're right around the corner.
Can't wait to go back home and work in Crystal Lake, where I live. Sorry, I need to get that out
there. There it is.
I guess it's about that time.
It's about that time.
Thank you guys for, you know, being with us for the holidays, you know.
We wish you all happiness and love, and hopefully you watch movies that are better.
And peace on earth.
Than the Hallmark and Netflix originals that have been coming out lately.
Or watch them for a good laugh.
Go watch Die Hard.
Watch Die Hard ironically.
Watch Die Hard seriously, because it's the best Christmas movie there is. Then go watch a crappy Hallmark movie and think about Jason.
Oh, thank you. Well, we're going to throw it back to Crosby and everybody at the station. You know, everyone, have a happy holiday. Keep listening to WJMU 89.5, The Quad.
Well, that's all from us here at WJMU. All your favorite programs will be returning at the beginning of next semester. Until then, from all of us here and on behalf of those who couldn't be here tonight, happy holidays.
That was the 2018 WJMU Holiday Special, hosted by Antonio Verdera as Crosby Bingsley. Featuring DJ Jay Burden Avenue of Devil's Advocate, the Psych Professor and DJ Mellow Yellow of the Psychedelic Experience, Jordan Comish and Megan Whitlock of Turn Back Tuesday, and the Owl Stretching Time Players, Brian Barker, Emily Bose, Erica Caruso, Ariane Evans, Aria Hawkins, Frank Macaluzzo, Garrett Mayberry, Yaselin Overa, Megan Pender, Michael Santos, Giovanni Tapia, and Ben Woodcock. This program was written and produced by Lane Casper, Jordan Comish, Caleb Kelch, Frank Macaluzzo, Sam Meister, Jason Messina, Matt Sands, and Megan Whitlock. The executive producer was Frank Macaluzzo. The sound editor was Sydney Stower. This is your announcer, Corey Lang, speaking.